Welcome everybody to the much anticipated hybrid planning video. I'm Elena and I'm going to be chatting with you guys today about how I use my digital tools, the native apps of Apple Notes, Reminders, and my iCal to help keep my shit together even though I use a bullet journal on a daily basis. Now, let's be real. I love pen and paper, but there's absolutely a time and place for using digital tools, and I found that keeping it as simple as possible is the most effective way to do it for me. And this means that this information also syncs up across my iPad and my iPhone and my MacBook without me having to really think about it. And so I know that the information will be at my fingertips regardless of whether I have my laptop with me or I have my phone with me. And also because my calendar is the main source of truth and the primary thing that I look at when I see what my availability is or I need to schedule an appointment, it also means that I don't always have to have my physical planner with me when it comes to managing appointments. But if my planner is my day-to-day task management system, how do the digital tools fit into this? I'll tell you how. Now, I tried several digital planning tools, and I actually really enjoyed trying to figure out what is the best platform. Is it Notion? Is it Asana? Is it ClickUp? Is it Motion AI? And I ended up realizing that the best and simplest and most effective tool were the native apps because I already knew how to use them because I had been using them for years because I've pretty much always had an iPhone, with the exception of my dalliance with Samsung. But when I opened my business, I ended up switching back to iPhone because the social media apps are more optimized for Apple products. And what I found was that setting up all of these different tools was really, really exciting, but I spent so much time trying to set it up and then feeling like I had to use it because I spent so much time setting it up that I, one, never got any work done because I spent more time setting it up than actually getting my work done. And two, I felt like I had to constantly add things to it. And because it was also so easy to add something to a digital inbox because there's usually a shortcut or you just push a button and then it's there, I was adding way too many things. And then if I didn't organize those things in exactly the right way when I added it or take the time to set up some kind of automation or rule to sort the information into the appropriate place, information would honestly get lost. So for me, falling back on the regular tools that I was using ended up being the most effective and efficient option so that everything was the same across all of my devices and the information was also easy to access and organize. Okay, so let's take a quick peek here at my digital calendar for the week of October 14th. I'm recording this on Tuesday, October 15th. So I use my iCal because while I do use Gmail as my primary email and Google Drive storage, I can sign into every single Google account that needs to show up on my calendar and all of it funnels directly into iCal. Now, rather than trying to find another app that might cost me money or that might not work as optimally across all my devices, this app lives natively on my iPhone and on my iPad. So I don't have to go download another app or create a password or log into anything. It already exists. So by logging into my different Google calendars in my iCal, I can see where everything is. And you'll notice that there's different colors for different types of events. And that means that it's just associated with a different calendar on my schedule. And because my clients primarily schedule online with me and my colleagues and I usually schedule things using a digital calendar, I don't have to worry about wondering where I have availability or where I can maybe fit things in. So the other benefit to this is that it exists on my phone. So I don't have to carry around my main system with my standard TN all the time, especially if I'm just out running errands. I have my schedule at my fingertips, which is really, really important. This iCal becomes the main reference for me when it comes to, again, looking at my availability, mapping out things. I can add as many things onto the iCal that I need to. I can mark in when I'm expecting my cycle so I know when to avoid booking a lot of appointments. I can mark in travel dates. I can mark in things that are happening 6, 8, 9, 10, 12 months from now and know that they will show up on my calendar once we get closer to that date so that I don't double book or overbook myself. Now, when it comes to task management, you might think, if you use your bullet journal as your main task manager during the week, how do you manage to add something to your to-do list if you don't have your notebook in front of you? And it's simple. I use reminders, and I will literally use the command, "Hey Siri, remind me at 10 a.m. tomorrow that I need to follow up with Sam's referral." And now it lives on my phone. Out and about, and I don't have my notebook with me, or I may be lying in bed and my notebook is in my office or it's in my backpack ready for me to go for the next day and I think of something, I will set a reminder on my phone to remind me at a specific time about a specific event. This means that I'm able to make sure that by the time I am sitting down somewhere with my notebook, the reminder pops up on my phone. And if I'm not at a place yet where I can write down that reminder, I will leave the notification up on my phone. I do have a weekly routine where I will go through and sweep everything, and that's how I keep everything aligned, and I'll show you what that looks like in a little bit. But using the reminders app and asking the reminders app to remind me on a certain day at a certain time about a specific thing means that when I don't have my notebook with me, I don't have to worry about remembering to write this down. Now, my default is yes, I prefer to physically write things down in my notebook because if it's not written down, it really doesn't exist in my brain. But I don't always have access to my notebook, and I don't like carrying around a second small planner because then I feel like I have to duplicate the information. And when I start duplicating information across books, that's when things fall through the cracks. I miss appointments, I miss to-dos, and I don't like missing things. So for me, it's easier to keep everything written down in here. And then in my reminders app, it doesn't get checked off until it lands in my bullet journal. Now, there's sometimes exceptions to that rule where occasionally I will leave things in my reminders app because I'm not ready to do anything with that information yet, but I review that during my weekly digital decluttering process. One of my other favorite features of the reminders app is if I am opening up a URL and I want to remind myself to reference this later, what I can do is I can actually hit the share link and I can send it to my reminders app and I can set a reminder, go into details and set a date and a time for this to remind me to follow up on this. Oops, let's turn on time. And I want it to remind me to check out this link at 9 a.m. tomorrow. So now again, I get that additional reminder from my reminders app. In my reminders app, here's a quick overview of some things that have been sort of living long term in my apps. So things to look into, things that I want to do in the morning, I grabbed the magnetic mount. See, I can do this. I did a recurring task dashboard. I did my Amazon returns. I'm still working on that. So anything that's still here in my reminders app, honestly, is in here because I'm not ready to do anything with that information yet. So it's better for it to just stay here so that when I sweep this for my weekly digital declutter, I can go back and reflect, is this something that I want to act on this week? No? Okay. It's just going to sit in my reminders app. Now, we've talked about iCal. We've talked about reminders. Let's talk about notes. You can't click on a URL from a notebook. So I use the notes app in my Apple Notes to help me keep track of information that comes in through the day, maybe organize notes from meetings that I have, especially recurring meetings that I have. Sometimes I will put a piece of education or research, or I will have sort of a master to-do list, especially if it's something that's associated with a URL, in which case I will note that in my notebook that this to-do is linked to my Apple Notes, and I'll say check notes for this course. So there is a course that I want to take. I have the link in my notes, and in my master to-do list, it says, take this GI map course and see notes. And so I know that the link to the course is in my notes, which really, really helps making sure that I have access to the resources that I need, but that I also have the to-do list written down. In addition, I find notes just a little more user-friendly compared to Google Drive when it comes to just keeping general notes. I don't need to put a bajillion documents into my Google Drive of random ass things that don't really need to be kept long term. So putting it in a note in my Apple Notes really makes the most sense because I can either organize that information later or delete it if it's not necessary. Very similar to how I migrate and assess things that I write down in my bullet journal. Here's me showing you Apple Notes, very basic. So if you're in the All iCloud, you will see all of your notes. However, I don't like to hang out here. My default setting here is just hanging out in my notes folder. I love Apple Notes because it's easily organized and very, very searchable, and you can link notes together. So if I create a new note for the hybrid planning video, if I want to link this to another note that I've brainstormed on, all I need to do is do the two little carrots, and it will automatically pop a bunch of things, either recent things that I've done, or I can type in the word that I know is in the title and link my hybrid planning tools. And then when I'm in this note, I can click here and it will open this up right here, which is super, super amazing. Really makes it very, very easy. Then when I want to take this note and organize it so that I'm not looking at everything all the time, I just drag it to the appropriate folder and or subfolder. So this is my completed planner videos notes, and this is everything that I'm currently brainstorming. So hopefully that gives you a little bit of context to some of the functionality of Apple Notes, that it is free, that it is searchable. So there you have it. So you guys can obviously see why I love Apple Notes. The additional benefit to Apple Notes is that it's very searchable. So even if you title something that doesn't quite make sense, if you search a word that you know you typed into that note, it will very easily pop up. And this is, again, available across my phone, across my iPad, and across my laptop. So regardless of where I'm at, all the information is the same across all my devices. My Apple Notes is my first line of defense for when I have to take notes for something on my computer, or if I need to house a URL somewhere, or I need to house long-term information that needs links attached to it, or I just don't necessarily need it in my bullet journal, or maybe it's sensitive information that needs to be kept behind a password. The additional benefit to leveraging these native Apple apps is that they are free. If you own a MacBook or an iPad or an iPhone, you will always have access to the Notes app, the Reminders app, and the iCal app. They get updated with the regular software updates that come through Apple, and I don't have to worry about this ever being stuck behind a paywall and then having to pay for access to the app or creating extra logins, because let's face it, I have enough logins to a bajillion different things. I don't need to worry about keeping another password. So now let's talk about the key component to this whole system that makes using something like my iCal plus my reminders plus my Apple Notes really, really effective. And this applies more to my notes and my reminders, is I need to do a weekly digital declutter. And this typically happens when I'm doing my planning for the upcoming week and I'm looking at my Google Calendar. And so I will sweep my reminders to see if there's anything in there that I need to either move into my notes or move into my planner. And again, if I'm not ready to do anything with that information, I just leave it there and I don't touch it because I just want it to exist in that space. But for my Apple Notes, I want to show you how I go through and organize my Apple Notes. So you're going to see on the left-hand side, I have a series of folders that I've created in my Apple Notes. And what I'm basically doing here is I'm just taking all of these notes that exist that I've added over the course of the last week or two, and I'm just dropping them into the folders that they belong to. And so this allows me to really make sure that the information stays organized, it doesn't clutter up the sort of front page of my Apple Notes, and that I am able to go through this and find the information later, but keep it out of sight, out of mind until I need it. Now, what's really nice about this process is if you forget to do it 1 week, you just do it maybe the next week. And if things build up a little bit, that's okay. But I do recommend going in at least once or twice a month to organize your notes. Otherwise, you have no idea what's in there. You add too many things. And again, the whole thing of it got really easy to add stuff. You don't go through and you delete the things that you don't need and then organize the information that you need to keep on hand. It starts to get really overwhelming. I had to actually go through and completely organize my Apple Notes a couple months ago before I fully switched over to just relying on the native systems. And I'm so glad that I took the time to do it. It didn't actually take me nearly as long as I thought it would, which was really, really nice. And now I have a system that is super, super functional, super clean. It doesn't cost me any money. It works seamlessly across all my devices, and the information is completely searchable. So again, this is just a quick peek into my hybrid planning system on how and why I use the iCal, the Apple Notes, and reminders on my Apple devices, and why they complement my core system of bullet journaling in my physical planner so well. It helps me keep the information organized. It helps me make sure that I'm adding things to my planner or pulling them from my planner and adding them to notes with reference to my notes as needed, and building in sort of a weekly sweep of my reminders and or notes, or at least bi-weekly sweeps of these two apps, keeps me on top of the information, deleting things I don't need, and really focusing on the information that I need to keep and maybe come back to later, but I'm just not ready to do anything with this information yet. This allows me to make sure that I'm actually using my time efficiently and effectively, that I waste less time setting things up or trying to get things super aesthetic, and that I actually use my tools for planning and productivity to help me do just that, to plan and be productive. If you guys liked today's video, please subscribe, smash that like button. And if you have any questions about how I'm using these tools that I maybe didn't cover in today's video, let me know. I'm happy to reply to the comment or maybe even do a follow-up video on some specifics. Maybe I should do a video on my notes specifically. Maybe I do a video on my reminders specifically. Let me know what you want to see, and I will definitely drop that for you guys. But until then, thank you guys so much for being here, and I'll catch you on the next one.